Take up all your sweet time, eh, on this Sunday afternoon. Eh. There you go. I said I meant to take up all your sweet time. Yes, I did. On this Sunday afternoon. See you again at Mickey. I see the next dive bar. Don't be late. Don't be late. I'm a fool child. Lord knows what I'm a fool child, babe. Said I'm a fool child. Lord knows what I'm a fool child. Lord knows I'm a boot champ. Bobby's got a hole in his snare drum, so we're going to play as long as we can. Our next set is going to last as long as the hole in Bobby's snare drum lasts. And then we're going to have to take a break. So.
No. We'll be okay. I want to say something while we got time to talk, I guess. Thank you guys for everybody that's bought a CD. I do so much appreciate that. Seriously, thank you. Thank you. We released that album about, I'll tell you guys a little bit about it. We released it about, I think it's been 8 months now. I don't know. We released it in June of 2016. It's 2017, right? So it's 2017. Never mind. So we released it about 5 months ago. it received a really good review from Blues Magazine. I don't know if any of you guys are familiar with that. Blues Magazine, it received a great review from that. And it's been getting some radio airplay from the United States as well as in the UK. So that's been so cool to hear some of our songs overplayed in Europe and stuff like that. It's been really, really cool.
It got a really bad review.
No, it didn't.
No, the one song.
It did get a really...
You can't please all the people all the time.
Yeah, that's true. It did. It got a really good review from Blues Magazine, and then Blues Magazine totally ripped one song a new ass,
So we said they don't know what they're talking about anyway, so fuck them.
So 10 out of 11 songs were good.
Yeah, fuck them. They wouldn't know good music if it slapped them in the face.
No problem, man. Who said Stevie Ray? I got no drummer right now, so I can play a little bit of Stevie Ray. Let's give it a go. I've had a bourbon shot, so let's give it a go, right? Let's be clear. Before I try this, we all know there is one Stevie Ray Vaughan. And there will always only be one Stevie Ray Vaughan. So we're going to give this one a go. Why not? There is one Shaw Davis. That's true. There's only one Shaw Davis. But we're going to give this one. I'll give this one a go.
Thank you.
going down.
We're down, 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 down.
Going down.
I'm going down, 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 down.
I got my big feet in the window. Take me down, you take me down, 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 down. Take me down, you take me down, down, down. I got my big feet in the window, I got my head. I'm going down, I'm going down, 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 down. I'm going down, yes, yeah. I'm going down, 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 down. I got my big feet in the window, I got my head. Take me down. You guys having a good time so far? Hey. Thank you so much. We're so glad to be here. Thank you, George, for having us here today. Thank you so much. How about a hand for George? Come on. Thank you, George. Thank you. So we're going to do a little cover tune right here. And this one's on the album that we have for sale here for today. This one's called little Johnny Cash tune. You guys might know this one. We got Bobby Van Stone back here on the drums. Sunshine since I don't know when. Well, I'm stuck in Folsom prison. Time keeps dragging on. Well, I hear that train coming my way home. When I was just a young boy, my mama told me, son, always be a good boy, don't you ever touch them guns. But I shot them in the Reno just to watch him die. I hear that train coming, I hang my head and cry. Was mine. I bet I move on a little bit further down the line. Far from Folsom prison, that's where I want to stay. And I'll hit that lonesome whistle, it blow my blues away. I'll blow away. So much.
Thank you guys again for hanging out with us. We're going to be here till 6 o'clock or till the cops come again. Or we're going to be here till 6 and then till the cops come. We are Shaw Davis and the Black Ties. We're going to tune up and play some more tunes for you.
Yes, I would. And one thing, I'd like to apologize, man. We got You know, there's always a couple of gigs sometimes where you got, like, massive gear failures, and that is today. So I do apologize for any of that that's going on. We got amps blowing. We got drum heads going. I don't know. Pat's got problems with the bass, man, but I do. Yeah, exactly. We'll get it all fixed. Yes, we do. It's okay. We're going to slow down a little bit. We're going to get some blues going. Things that I used to do, Lord, I won't do no more. The things that I used to do, Lord, I won't do no more. I used to search all night for you, darling, and cry with my memory too. I used to search all night for you, darling. Lord, in my search would always end in bed. I used to search all night for you, darling, cry with my family too. Now you know all the time now, darling, that you was hit out with some other man. I used to search all night for you, darling. Alone in my search would always end in vain. things to search, you're not your darling. Alone in my search will always end. Cause you know all the time now, darling, that you was hit out with some other man. There's your Stevie Ray Vaughan on the back right there. Well, I'm done running to my baby, and I finally found my old blue jean. Thank you. I ever get back my Beijing. Lord, how happy can a one man be? If I is when I get back my blue jeans, yeah, and my baby, I bring him home to me. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Someone go grab me a PBR on our band tab, pretty please. We gotta keep playing, I can't do it myself.
She let me down
about my baby.
way down now.
She's going way down.
Just came back from.
Just came back from.
Just came back.
Just came back from.
I don't know now.
I don't know now.
Tell me now, baby. Have you seen her? Have you seen her?
Have you seen her?
I don't know now. Thank you. me if that's 6 it turned out to be 9 oh, baby, I don't mind. Oh, baby, I don't mind. Oh, when I fall them hippies, when I fall the head, oh, baby, I don't care. Yeah, no, I feel it too. Cause like I'm playing, I'm like something is itching.
I thought it was crazy.
Well, we just found out that we have fleas. It happens. It's a price to pay.
We're going to get to it.
Thank you.
picture. I said, where you going with that? You're gonna go, hey. Picture. I said, where you going with that? You're gonna go, hey. I'm gonna mess around with another man. Gonna shoot my leg. You know I'm gonna mess around with another man. Hey, Joe. Heard you shot your lady down. Hey, Joe. I heard you shot your lady down. Shot her down. Yes, I did. I shot her. You know I call my lady mess around town. In a shot. You know I caught my lady messing around. Yeah, yeah. We'll be right back.
All right. Rory Gallagher tune. I hope that's cool with you guys. All right, here we go. There's a good story about Rory Gallagher. And that's that, you know his Strat, right? You know Rory Gallagher's Stratocaster, right? You know how beat it is, right? It's the most beat Strat you ever seen in your entire life. There's no pain on the thing, you know? Well, there's a story that it was stolen from him after a show and a gig, right? And somebody who stole it, you know, but by the time he had had it, it's a very identifiable, I'm sorry, geez, identifiable Strat. Sorry. You got me too many shots. I mean, there's only one, but I'm just kidding. I'm like 150 pounds, though, you know? And so anyway, no, Rory's Strat was stolen from him, and it was thrown into a ditch for like 2 months, right? And it was finally recovered, so when Rory got it back, it was, you know, that just adds to the story of it, right? For two whole months, Rory's Strat was sitting outside in the rain and the weather or whatever for 2 whole months. And when he got it back, you know, he probably just strung it up and played it, just like Rory would have done, you know? Dude was a total badass.
To miss on my plane, well, I think you know how it was when I tripped and fell. But you double dear, my baby, crack like a shell. Round and around, I was with my leg, and I was no lost and found. Well, I think you know how it was when I tripped and fell. But you doubled in my baby, a crack like a shell. Let me tell you, some stormy nights, your memory haunts me. I can't go there. You know how it was when I round trip different. But you never deal me, baby. I grab my your shit.
See if you sit on the bass, y'all. Come on, Bobby.
We'll be right back.
64. Oh, wait, I was going to use that for the next one. I got it from my my great uncle, who used to own Pompano Beach Trim Shop. I used to do like upholstery and stuff like that. He owned it from, I don't know, from the 50s up until the 80s. And when he gave it to me, it's when I first started. My father was him and my father. They were rebuilding the 68 Camaro up in his shop that he still has today. It's like his hangout place. You know, it's not open or anything. He pays for it and he just hangs out in there all single day. He's got bunch of Chevelles, some Novas, and he's got an old Camaro in there, a 68 Camaro that him and my father were restoring. And so when I was about 16, I'd go in there and all they'd make me do was hold the flashlight, you know. I wasn't worthy enough to try and work on this car. So I just hold the flashlight, and finally I got sick of that, and I just went into the back room and started playing. He had like, you know, six or seven guitars back in his office room, you know. There was like a separate room in his office. And so I just started playing the guitar back there, and that's where I first started playing. And that's this. How old was I? I was 16 when I first started playing. Yeah, 21 now. And yeah, this old Strat was back there, and so I just, you know, I'd always play it. And he finally gave it to me. the original neck is in, like I said, it's in about four pieces. I'm not kidding when I say that. The original neck on this guitar, which is a shame because, you know, it really was a. It was a great guitar. Oh, and it still is, you know, it still is. It really is. But it's got a replacement neck on it. I had to take the neck off my other guitar and replace that. Well, that's good. That's good. Thank you. And, yeah, it tries to stay in tune. It's, you know, it tries its best. It's close enough for rock and roll. And so, yeah, that's the story behind it, you know. It's got two original pickups in it. One's a replacement. This bridge pickup's a replacement. And I love it, man, you know. Absolute baby. It's the best thing ever. Some days it sounds better than others. We're going to let loose on you guys right here. We got one more for you right here. This one's going to be good. Thank you guys so much for hanging with us today. We so appreciate it. Thank you. Patrick Seams here on the bass. Bobby Van Stone back here on the drums. My name is Sean Davis. Thank you guys so much. Thank you. Thank you. We hope to be back. We hope to be back. Thank you guys so much. Thank